How are files stored on disk? The simplest way to think of it would be to have every file stored sequentially in the order in which it was created. This, however, has an obvious problem. When a file changes size, you can't just write over the file in front of it. Instead, you have to add some onto the end of the disk. We use inodes to keep track of these broken up pieces of files.
The disk is divided into equally sized blocks, each of which can be assigned to any file. If a file is larger than a single block, it is put into multiple blocks. Each file has an inode associated with it that stores which blocks make up the file. All inodes are the same size and are stored in an array in the superblock. Their consistent size makes it easy to look them up.
An inode stores more than just data. For example, you might want to know when a file was created, what its size is, how many links there are to it, or who created the file. Each inode, therefore, has blocks and metadata. When you want to see the data of the file, the inode can tell you all the blocks that contain that data. Or when you want to know more about the file itself, you can get the metadata.
So you have a file, inode 2, for example. And in the operating system, you can have a bunch of file names that point to this file. So you could have readme, you could have help, etc. All of these are links to the same inode. So when you open one of these, it displays the data that's in the blocks referenced by that inode.
Remember, all inodes are stored in the inode table in the superblock. Each of them is the same size. Let's look at inode 2. If it were to represent a file 40 blocks long, you'd think it would contain 40 block pointers. But no, since inodes are a tiny pre-allocated size, they simply don't have enough room for 40 block pointers. This is where indirect blocks come into play.
Each inode has an array of 12 block pointers. The standard block size is 4 kilobytes, which means you have 4 times 12, or 48 kilobytes, of storage. So what do you do when you have a file larger than that? Well, that's not the whole story. In addition to the 12 block pointers, an inode also contains 3 indirect block pointers, which will help. Each indirect block points to a block of block pointers, greatly expanding an inode's capacity.
Indirect blocks can also point to other indirect blocks, creating double or treble indirect blocks. This even further expands the capacity of an inode. Think about it. You have limited space to store references to direct blocks. So why use all that space to store references to direct blocks? Even the indirect blocks shouldn't all point to direct blocks when you can just point to more indirect blocks. This gives you file sizes of up to 4 terabytes. Representing files as a table of inodes has some interesting side effects. For example, you can run out of file space without actually running out of disk space. Your inode table is a limited size, and if you have a whole ton of really tiny files, you might run out of spaces in your inode table before you run out of disk space. It's worth noting that inodes are a Unix thing. Apple and Microsoft both have their own file systems. Apple's HFS Plus uses a catalog file, which is analogous to inodes. Microsoft's NTFS uses file record attributes, which also serve the same purpose.